Alright guys, welcome back. In this video, we're going to be using the PicoScope, and I'm going to show you how to test an inductive style camshaft sensor. So we already got our scope hooked up and turned on. First thing we're going to do is we're going to come up to the automotive tab. We're going to go to sensors. We're going to go to camshaft. And then we're going to go to inductive. Now it's going to set up our scope for us. It's also going to open our web browser, and it's going to go right up to the how to connect oscilloscope tab that's already open for you. And there's something pretty specific here you have to read. It tells us that we can use this TA012 2-pin test lead adapter. That is actually this one right here, and that is what we're going to be using. That is the connector on our sensor. So we'll be using that. Let's see here. It tells us to probe each of the two connections until a larger waveform is displayed. The smaller waveform is returned to Earth. So that's what we're going to do. Because we don't know which wire is which, there's our sample waveform. We're going to go ahead and we're going to get this running. I'm going to show you the connections we have on the car. We're going to go ahead and start it up and see which one of them is our signal wire. So you can see our jumper lead, the TA012 Pico lead. It's plugged right into the cam sensor right here, easy to get to on this car, right on top of the valve cover. We've got our negative lead hooked to the negative terminal on the battery. Over here I've got both of these open still, and our Pico lead right here. So we're going to start the car, we're going to probe into one of the connections, probe in the other one, while we watch our scope and see which one of them is going to produce our signal. Alright, I'm going to go start the car. Probe one of the wires now. We can see that's likely our signal, our ground wire, and that is our cam signal wire. I've got just a little bit of noise on there. I'm gonna let that collect a little bit. We're gonna go ahead and stop, and I'm gonna shut the car off. We can see we got a beautiful little signal there. A little bit of noise. So if we want to clean that up a little bit, we're going to apply a little bit of filtering. And there we go. There is our cam signal. As I've mentioned before, you're going to want to make sure you pop back on your web browser with the page that they opened when you selected the test. You're going to want to go down through. They give some example waveforms. I've got some waveform notes here, some technical information on the sensor and the style sensor, what it's likely used for, and other things to look out for. So be sure to log in there and check that out. And as always, make sure you save your waveform, particularly if you know it's a known good. We'll click the Save As tab, we're gonna fill out the vehicle information, and we're gonna click the Save and Share to add to the Pico library. All right guys, pretty simple test. That is using your Pico to check the cam signal on an inductive style camshaft sensor. Thanks for watching.